Rome, the eternal city, La Città Eterna. Here, tourists come with idealistic visions of the city's past, its legacy, its romance. But how many see Rome as it is, as it awakens each day? Rome is home to over 3.7 million citizens. It hosts more than 9 million visitors every year. Those visitors who come here all have a choice before them when they arrive. Will they stick to a guidebook? Will they want to go deeper? There is a competition within and against this city that the traveler must take part in order to understand Rome.
Forte cazzone con un stemma a rete, una cupulella che vi si era aizzata, passa scampaniando per tu l'ete, con mano a papà te fa guardare. Tu vuoi fare l'americano, americano, americano, senta a me chi tu fa fare. Vuoi vivere alla moda, ma se bevi whisky e soda, poi ti senti disturbato. Tu abballo rock and roll, tu gioca a baseball, me sorda beccamel, chi te li dà la borsetta di mamma, tu fa l'americano, americano, americano. Ma si nati in Italia, siente a me non c'è sta niente fa, ok napolitan, tu vuoi fare l'American, tu vuoi fare l'American.
Rome is not only called the Eternal City for its long-standing importance to history. The city's collection of holy sites gives tourists an impression of its connection to an eternal and spiritual power beyond the monuments. The Vatican alone draws more than 4 million visitors every year. But many religious sites are owned by private companies, turning ancient pilgrimage sites into pricey tourist traps. For centuries, pilgrims traveled to worship at St. Peter's Prison, where the apostle was held before his crucifixion. This tour group operates a bus that goes all over the holy sites of Rome, capitalizing on the religious tourism of the Eternal City. But not all religious sites in Rome fall under the net of commercialized pilgrimage. Built in the 4th century, Santa Maria in Trastevere is one of the oldest churches in Rome, the first where Mass was legally allowed to be celebrated, and contains a piece of the sponge that Christ was given a drink from while hanging on the cross. Virtually no tourists come here. The basilica is quiet, filled with hallowed silence during the day, but it is never empty. Parishioners stop in throughout the day to volunteer time to help the community or simply light a candle in prayer. Even if you are not religious, this place proves that some ancient places in Rome have resisted the crowds and commercialism. Rome is many things to many people, but first and foremost, as a tourist first arrives, it seems to be a city that is situated around and thriving off of its monuments. We found artists, vendors, and tourists throughout the city with different views on monuments, tourism, and Rome itself. This is Roberto, a painter and a native Roman. He and his brother sell their paintings in Piazza Navona.
In Piazza Navona is the last square, the last place in Roma where you can meet Michelangelo people. I mean, you met tourists, but you met also a lot of kinds of Romans. So, adesso Piazza Navona è uno dei salotti buoni di Roma. The other one has gone. I think this is the last one.
This is Elsa, who works at Quetzalcoatl Chocolatier near the base of the Spanish Steps. She and her mother are French Sicilian, and the chocolates that they make and sell are just as beautiful and unique as the steps nearby.
Era molto importante essenzialmente per la moda di Roma in quel periodo, diciamo. Purtroppo adesso non c'è più questa cosa E il momento magico di Piazza Spagna è quando arriva la primavera, che la mettono tutti i fiori su tutta la scalinata, e allora lì la scalinata rivive, diciamo, perché purtroppo un po' tutto l'anno si vedono tanti turisti seduti sopra, e secondo me quando ci sono i turisti che si siedono così sulle scale, perde un po' della sua bellezza che, c'è, che avrebbe, diciamo, se non la vedessi vuota tutta fino alla Trinità dei Monti, ecco.
Di vedere Roma sia di giorno ma anche di notte, perché di notte ha un fascino particolare, perché nessuna altra città in Europa, Roma si cambia, di notte è un aspetto, di giorno è un altro.
The crowds and the commercialism crash against a new visitor. Only by going deeper can a person coming to Rome find a Rome that is truly theirs. Then, the marvelous. The passive tourist becomes an active traveler. Rome opens up, and the city shares its secrets. So what is Rome? Is it a disappointment? The prices, the crowds, the vendors all block the easy view of the iconic sites that many who come to Rome just expect to be there, waiting to be viewed like they are in the movies. What is the city's meaning when so many spiritual sites cost money, are hampered by tourism and man-made trappings, when the historical sites you've wanted to ponder are covered in scaffolding and billboards? Rome has always been a city of conflict. The Republic clashed with the rise of the Empire, pagans clashed with Christians, and all the peoples brought by trade or by conquest mixed in the city. After the Empire's fall, religions continued to clash. When Rome began to rise again, popes clashed with the remnants of the city's history, building the Campidoglio to block the view of the Roman ruins, which weren't considered fashionable in the Baroque era. Mussolini did the same thing in the 20th century when he bulldozed many medieval neighborhoods in order to highlight those same ruins that had been 500 years ago so ugly to those in power. Rome has always been a circus. From the remnants of the Colosseum to the outline of the Piazza Navona, Rome's racetracks remain part of the city's entertainment to this day. And though the entertainment has changed, the spirit of Rome's citizens to always be putting on a show has never faded away. Dealing with the circus of Rome can be difficult.
You cannot imagine how many people try to destroy it, but it has the, you know, antigorpi. You know when a virus attacks you, we call it antigorpi. Rome has got a very, very antigorpi.
Romans have found a place to refresh themselves in the midst of this chaotic city.
Cioccolatini mangiati ed è la sera, all'ora del tramonto, tutte le sere c'è un tramonto completamente diverso ed è bellissimo da vedere. Credo che ancora chi vive a Roma e che va tutte le sere lì, tutte le sere si emoziona, perché poi c'è questa vista magnifica su tutta Roma ed è splendida.
Piace a Roma Villa Borghese, perché adoro il vento, per cui Villa Borghese dà un senso di libertà.
So taking their advice, we end up here. The Villa Borghese is a 148-acre park in the north of Rome. These grounds used to be Cardinal Borghese's personal vineyards, but were landscaped for his villas in 1605, and were open to the public a little over 100 years ago. This is where Romans go to get away from it all. This is the magical, liberating spot Romans have spoken of, a getaway from the commercialized touristy areas. This city can be incredibly intimate and quiet if you wander enough alleys to find a place to roam. So what do you do? you can find a quiet space away from the crowds to reflect on the city and to find a place within the city that is unique and personal to the traveler. Travelers see a place for what it is, not for what the movies made it seem like before they arrived. To be a traveler rather than a tourist, you realize that the crowds are part of Rome, for better or worse, just as Rome is now part of you, the traveler. Rome is not a fairy tale versus the frenzy. It is both.
Che cos'è l'amore? Chiedilo al vento. Che sferza sul lamento, sulla Gaia, dal viale del tramonto. Alla mega gelata, chi ha perso il suo gazebo. Guai alla stagione, andata all'ombra del lampione San Suscito.